we can deviate off this baseline for those goal-specific things. Okay, what kind of goals would we deviate for? Somebody that needs to be a gainer. Okay, maybe they can't compete at the level that they want to right now because they're not able to move weight because of their size. So we're gonna up the block intake so that we can put on a little bit of weight, train with heavier weights, and then hopefully as we cut down back for the CrossFit Games or the regionals or the open or whatever you're gonna be competing at, whatever level that is, then we can cut back down and hopefully retain the strength but lose that excess body fat so that we can still move quickly. Okay, so we've got the gainer. Let's dive into that a little bit. Now, typically in the strength and conditioning world, you know, especially when we look at like power lifters where they're putting on a massive amount of weight so that they can move and use their leverage, we just talk about eating garbage, right? How many Big Macs should I eat today? How many French fries and shakes should I eat? Because it's calorically very dense. Okay, it still gives, they're still thinking macronutrients as well, but at the same time, they're just eating garbage many times, okay? We tend to think that it would make more sense to apply the zone block prescription where we're balancing macronutrients and we've got the quality sources to see the most favorable results, okay? So if we were to say, and this is something that we've talked about with numerous athletes, we've tested out in gyms, Chris has worked on it on his own, we found that 4,000 calories a day is a great place to start to increase that body weight. Now, this is gonna change per person, obviously, but if we've got somebody that's trying to put on 10 to 15 pounds, that's a lot of weight. It's a lot of weight, and this is a lot of calories. How many? Roughly 49 blocks. Now, does that really seem like a lot of food? Yeah, it does. It's a big time, right? Now, with that said, there's another option, because when you look at 49 blocks, if we spread that out over 5 meals, we're looking at 10 blocks per meal pretty much. That's insane. It's insane, okay? So what we can do is we can pick the most calorically dense macronutrient of the three, protein, carbs, and fat. What's that gonna be? Fat, absolutely. There's 9 calories per gram. So we can choose to intake a little bit more of the most calorically dense of those three, which is fat. And we can say, okay, let's make this manageable. Let's do 30 blocks. Okay, that divides easily into 6 blocks per meal. And then we're gonna do times 5x fat. Okay? And to give you an idea, if we actually did times 4x fat, it's 4,080 calories. Okay? Just to make it round numbers, I threw in the 5x. You guys choose. How picky do you want to be? Now, that's not it. Here's the thing about this. 4,000 calories a day or 30 blocks with 5x fat, that will put on weight up to a certain point. Now, if your hard gainer does not reach the goal weight that he or she has set, we need to readdress. When they plateau, when they hit that point where it's like, oh crap, you know, I'm still 5 pounds shy and I've been at that 5 pounds shy for 2 weeks now, I obviously need to change that a little bit more. And what we recommend doing is adding 3 whole blocks, which equates to 250 calories. Keep the 5x fat the same, and we're looking at about 300 to 400 calories. Okay, now what that's gonna do is that's gonna take your total caloric intake up. We're gonna see your body weight go up for a little bit, and then you may plateau again. And every time you plateau for any period of time, we're gonna up it again. So that's what we're looking at for a hard gainer. Do you guys have any questions about that?
Does that matter, male or female, for the +3 after the plateau, or no, doesn't matter at all?
You know, this is based off a male with the 4,000 calories. I would maybe tend to shy away from 4,000 calories for a female and maybe try something closer to 2,500 or 3,000.
Yeah.
Yep. And we just have to sit down and do some quick math to figure out exactly what block prescription that would be.
What math would you do to find out for a female? You know, off the top of your head?
Yeah, you would just, let's see. So if you would take You know, we've never, Chris, have you ever tested this on a female in your gym?
No, I don't know any females that want to put on a female.
Yeah, most females are not gonna, most females are not gonna want to put on a ton of body fat just to increase performance. But if we wanted to do it, I mean.
So it'd be 30 blocks, or if you want to make it realistic, go 20, you go 20 plus. Three times, 3x
fat. Yeah, I mean, basically, it's deviating off of that baseline and seeing what happens. Okay, but this is a very calculated way that's going to show results. That's going to show results without a doubt. And it's again, we're picking a method and we're going with it. We've seen it tested and it works, and we can deviate even off of that. If that's too much body fat too fast, we decrease it. Okay, but again, if you've got a method, you've got a way. Now, with that said, I want to throw out there that there really is no healthy way to overfeed an organism long term. This is not healthy. Okay, and it's really worth making your athlete know that, so that when they're happy at this body weight that's very excessive, they need to realize that, hey guys, this is not something you want to do for a long period of time. This is for your training specific goals. Yeah.
What do you recommend? That's a lot of carbohydrate blocks, especially if you're eating clean.
Yep.
What are the recommended sources to cram all that stuff in?
Okay, that's a great question. So if we look at 30 carbohydrate blocks and we choose broccoli, you are going to turn into a salad shooter. That's all there is to it, okay? A food processor is what you're going to turn into. And we don't want that to happen. So the things that I've seen work the best is stuff like sweet potatoes, more starchy foods, okay? And really, I mean, that's a great source of carbohydrate to form glycogen. So, I mean, what we're looking at is a very dense source of carbohydrate and also a fairly good choice. Like squash, absolutely. Stuff like that. Chris?
Yes, one thing I think Matt said it is when there's no healthy way to overfeed. One thing I noticed, and I think this is something you guys have to accept for your athletes to do this, is a ton of omega sixes. Still a lot of carbs, you're gonna get puffy, you're gonna get stiff, you're gonna get sore, it's gonna suck. Like, there's a point in time where it's gonna suck, but just like Matt said, work out, try to get a couple pounds over where you wanna be, then you start to dial things back in, you're still gonna have to support it, but that stiffness, all that crap goes away. So you have to accept some form of not so ideal.
Right, and with that increased level of omega-6 that we're taking in every single day, an easy way to decrease some of the symptoms of being pro-inflammatory, of having such a pro-inflammatory diet, obviously we can up our level of fish oil, okay, and try to balance that out as much as possible. But again, you can overdo fish oil. We've all experienced that at some degree.